Welcome to Lincoln Park Zoo. We are so happy you're with us. Today on Stay Tuned to the Zoo, we are hanging out in the free flight habitat at the McCormick Bird House. And during our chat today, we are gonna learn how expert care makes mealtime more than a feeding. Before we begin, I want you to ask yourself, have you seen a bird today or during the week? Your answer is probably yes, and that's because birds are all around us. They inhabit nearly every part of the world, and there's over 10,000 known species today. The bird world is diverse, and so is our free flight habitat. This space around me has 15 different species sharing space together. Here at Lincoln Park Zoo, mealtime is a great opportunity to care for the complexity of the species that share this space. Food is a wonderful opportunity to monitor the birds' everyday health and even ask them to participate in their care sessions. A really important part of feeding is our keepers locating all of the birds that call this habitat home. As they're walking out into the habitat to collect bowls from previous feedings, they're gonna look for birds around their space. They wanna check on the bird's overall body condition. They wanna look at their beak or bill, their feet, and also how they move throughout their space. When they're replacing those bowls, they also wanna look how much food is left from the previous feeding. This is a great way to monitor the overall health just by looking at how much food is left over. In this space, there are a lot of different birds, and different birds occupy different parts of the habitat, whether it's down low, up high, or near the water that you might hear in the background. The diets that we provide here go out to those special locations, so we're meeting the birds where they like to spend their time. For example, the fish eaters oftentimes will look for their food near the water. So our care staff will place those bowls filled with fish and krill near the water to encourage that nice natural behavior. For our fruit eaters, a lot of these birds will perch up high in the treetops. So our keepers will place these food bowls just a couple feet off of the ground for them. And last but not least, our seed and grain eaters will always be looking for their food near the ground. And there's a lot of shrubbery there to provide some privacy for these shy, secretive species as well. So our care staff will place those bowls on the ground, meeting the birds where they're at. The diets for the birds in this space are all carefully planned. Our animal care team work really closely with the veterinarians and the nutrition center right here at Lincoln Park Zoo. The diets are generally modeled after the diets that these birds would find and search for in the wild. So for these zoo-born individuals, having a healthy diet is part of having healthy birds. Now let's go back to those three different diets that we talked about. The first diet of fish is for our fish-eating birds. A fancy word for fish-eating is piscivore. My favorite fish-eating bird in the free flight habitat is right behind me on the boardwalk. This is a beautiful bird called a hammercup. These birds are native to Africa and will usually sit high on trees around wetland habitats. You'll notice on their body, they have a really long, slender bill with a sharp curved edge to the end. This is a perfect tool for catching fish. You might also notice on the boardwalk around them is a smaller gray bird. These are Inca terns. Although they look a lot different than the hammercup, they're also fish eaters, and you can tell because of that long, slender, sharp bill. These birds are gonna be looking near the water to catch their food. So again, where our keepers place their diet here in free flight. The fruit eaters that live in our free flight habitat are often gonna be perching up high in the trees. Oftentimes these birds are brilliantly colored, and you might get the chance to see some of them behind me. Right up above me on top of the tree is a golden-breasted starling. The blues and greens and yellows that they have all over their body are brilliantly beautiful, almost like the colors of their fruit diet. These birds usually have wide and short bills that they'll use to crush up the berries and other parts of their diet. Now, last but not least again are those granivores, or seed and grain eaters. These birds like to spend time down low on the forest floor, and oftentimes they'll use their feet to scratch at the surface looking for their food. The seed and grain eaters in here are often found down low too. My favorite is the Nicobar pigeon. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, a pigeon, how could that be your favorite animal? These birds are gorgeous with iridescent blue, green, and purple feathers covering their body. One thing that most of the bird species in here share is an interest in insects. That's why care staff have canisters filled with crickets, mealworms, waxworms, and super mealworms to scatter feed out into the habitat. Let's take a glance at that now. Our keeper will use her hands, reach inside the canisters, and scatter the insects all over the boardwalk and throughout the bird's habitat. This is really beneficial for many reasons. First and foremost, it encourages the movement of the birds in the space. Coming out on the boardwalk gives the birds a chance to stretch their wings. It also gives them a chance to come into a different area. That way our zookeepers can monitor and observe their behaviors. This is also a great form of enrichment. It promotes and encourages that natural foraging behavior. You can see the mast, flapwing, and the Inca tern out now, searching and looking for those insects on the boardwalk. You might even notice that the Inca terns might swoop down and try and grab insects as they're being tossed mid-flight. This is a great way to encourage their natural behavior of catching food quickly. Insects are also a great positive reinforcement used during training sessions. Because it is a really highly preferred food item, care staff will use it as a reward when birds station in certain areas. You'll notice now the Inca terns are stationed all over the boardwalk and on branches throughout their habitat. This is a great behavior that our zookeepers can ask for and shape, and this gets the birds closer to voluntarily stepping on a scale for weight. As you can imagine, this is a great way to monitor their health, and asking them to participate using positive reinforcement is a great way to do it. I hope you had the chance today to learn something new about the beautiful, diverse world of birds. I hope you also enjoyed learning about how expert care makes mealtime more than a feeding here at our free flight habitat. It's important to remember, though, that our care staff are professionals, and they spend a lot of time researching to know how to care for these beautiful species. If you observe birds in your own backyard, it's really important to remember to observe and not disturb. This can actually help those species thrive in their environment and keep them healthy. It also allows you a great opportunity to practice some scientific skills observing these birds and maybe even using some of the skills to identify them that you learned today. Thanks again for joining us.
Now that we learned all about what the birds in our free flight area in the zoo eat, let's look at some examples of birds that we might see around here, even at Nature Boardwalk at Lincoln Park Zoo. What we have here in front of us are a few different types of food that we might commonly see birds eating around here. And so the examples that we have are these mice that represent small mammals, insects and worms that we might have either on land or in water, fish, produce like these fruits right here, and then seed. One thing that we're gonna notice about birds and their beaks is that they're specially adapted to eat certain types of food. So what we can do is, as we're looking at each one of these types of birds right here, we can guess what type of food we think they eat. So the first example that we have is a red-tailed hawk. The red-tailed hawk has this really curved, sharp beak for, you know, eating. So what do we think that this red-tailed hawk might eat? Hopefully you guessed small mammals. Yes, they use that sharp beak to eat small mammals like mice and squirrels down at Nature Boardwalk. Another bird we might see down inside the pond there is this heron. This heron has a really long, pointy beak. What do you think they use that long, pointy beak for? Hopefully you guessed to eat fish. They use that beak to stab fish in the water and then gulp it down. Another bird that you might see down at Nature Boardwalk is a duck, and ducks have kind of an in-between size beak. It's not real long, but it's real wide. And you may also notice that it has these little row of lamellae to help push the water out but keep the food that they're foraging for inside their mouth. They eat a lot of aquatic plants, but they also will eat aquatic insects. Another bird that's really common to see around Nature Boardwalk and even in Chicago is the crow. The crow has sort of a long, medium-sized beak, pointy, and the thing about crows is they're pretty general in what they'll eat. They'll eat pretty much anything out here. So we could put them next to any one of these, either fish, insects, fruits, even grains or small mammals. The last one that we can look at is the northern cardinal, the state bird. A common bird to see in Chicago and at Nature Boardwalk. And they have a really stout beak that's really good for crushing things. So what do you think they might eat? Hopefully you guessed grains. They're really good at finding and eating seeds. Well, I hope you had fun guessing what kinds of food birds eat, and thanks for joining Stay Tuned to the Zoo. Subscribe for new videos every Tuesday and Thursday.